lose, but no more. Take 5 seconds out.
Oh, sorry, hang on.
Alright, next up I've got the story that was done on me last year on the morning show. Just giving you a bit of a background on where I'm coming from, so enjoy.
Thank you, how are you? Time now to catch up with a bloke who's been serenading us all year on the morning show. But I've got to tell you, the world of our bedroom philosopher, Justin Hazelwood, is still a bit of a mystery to us, though he does fling the door open occasionally to allow us to hear the songs he writes. So we decided our reporter, Chris Scaddan, should go straight to the course and take a guided tour of Justin's bedroom. And underneath the piles of clothes and books on the floor, he found a whole lot of cassettes. So Chris pressed record on his tape deck and asked our bedroom philosopher to explain himself.
I met Kelly in the supermarket deli.
Hi, g'day. I'm Justin Hazelwood. I am the bedroom philosopher. And you're currently in my room, which is located in sunny Belconnen in Canberra. The first thing I'm going to tell you about is sort of this lifelong obsession I've had of recording my family. I was an only child, so quite often my main form of entertainment was getting out the cassette recorder and hiding it behind the couch and waiting for Nan and Pop and Mum to start firing up. So here's just a little bit of an example of when Boonie took a classic catch against the West Indies. My Nan got excited.
Oh, blast,
so you just used to just carry a tape recorder around everywhere?
Yeah, well, I only had like sort of a big sort of 80s stereo beatbox sort of thing, so I sort of couldn't ever get outside the house. I'm going crazy. But then when I was about, I think 17 for Christmas, I got a little Walkman that recorded, and that was sort of just the greatest thing I ever got, because I'd take it to parties, I'd take it to school, just walk around the street. I don't know, this idea of capturing reality, I suppose. It was like my own reality.
So it's like the Osbournes, except it's the Hazelwoods.
Absolutely. I'm just wondering if somehow I can sort of package it and sell it as an idea, the Hazelwoods. Because it's just, I think it's brilliant. Well, I'm going to tell you about the guitars that I use. The first guitar was Ken, and he's a guitar that I've sort of had since I was 18. And he sort of wrote about maybe the first half of the songs I've done as a bedroom philosopher, but then Ken sort of started to get a bit old. So I decided to splash out on a new, beautiful, more beautiful guitar, and that's Kelly. And I called her Kelly because the first song I wrote in her was Kelly the Deli Girl.
I met Kelly in the supermarket deli. I wasn't looking for love, I was just after a cheap shook. I took a number and waited in turn. Then my ears began to burn. It was like that movie Sliding Doors. I was Gwyneth Paltrow in a pair of parachute pants.
Well, people often ask, like, what is bedroom philosophy? Well, actually, no one's asked yet, but when they do, I've figured out what it is. I think it's just those sort of things you think to yourself when you're, you know, lying in bed at night and you can't sleep, or you just wake up in the morning. I don't really have any philosophy books, or I guess I haven't really studied it per se, but I'm sort of trying to write my own little sort of book of bedroom philosophy on my laptop.
What else have you got on tape? Any other, any more family holidays?
March 1st, 1996, I was able to program 15 minutes of Triple J radio. You had to send in your 5 favourite songs. And this is when Tunny rang me up.
Giving Justin a call here in Burnie in Tasmania. It's our high five.
Hello?
Hello, is Justin there?
Yep.
Hey, Justin. Michael Tunn here from Triple J.
Are you going to play it?
I am going to play it.
Great.
So here we go. Number 5, do you remember what you put in at number 5?
Infinity by Guru Josh.
I love this.
Nobody remembers it.
I remember it.
Yeah, I loved it.
It was some 1990s dance trash, yeah. And I loved it. Here it is. Here it is for you, mate. Whatever happened to Guru Josh? That's all I want to know.
Yeah.
Enjoy your high five.
I can't believe you chose Guru Josh.
Oh, mate, it's actually, the funny thing is, that's my favourite song of all time. But I put it at 5 because I, for some reason, didn't think they'd have it. But for some reason, that song out of all songs in the world is just the most important to me. And I used to play it so much just to get me, you know, pumped up for things. And yeah, Guru Josh. Just the audacity to claim a whole decade as your own. 1990s, time for the Guru. I actually, on the New Year's Eve 1999, I just for a little while I had a little thought, I wonder what Guru Josh is thinking, you know, because that's the end of his 1990s reign. What's he going to do now?
Of course it's Guru Josh. He's probably hiding under your bed, Justin. You just haven't found him underneath all the cassettes. Justin Hazelwood, our bedroom philosopher, and his grandma getting excited about it. Boonie catch, no doubt, he was fielding at short leg and he just stuck the big paw out and the ball stuck in his hand. And didn't she enjoy that one? And of course, the bedroom philosopher will be part of ACT Unearthed, which is happening this Sunday, September 22nd. Robbie Buck will be in town to announce the winners live from the nation's capital between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. And Justin will be there with Kelly to play a song that he's written specifically for our Canberra ACT Unearthed event. Sunday night in the refectory at the Uni of Canberra, the winners will play a free concert with special guest Body Jar rocking along as well. And to enjoy it all, Justin will be there, no doubt. Ask him for his autograph. Ask him where Guru Josh is. I'm sure he's done the research now and knows exactly where you can find him. This is my favourite Justin Hazelwood Bedroom Philosopher song. If you're not had any morning tea or breakfast yet, I suggest you listen closely.
I'm not one to make a statement. I'm anything but blatant. Of life, I am but a quiet member. But I'll never forget that day when out in the open it all came. Had to be that one day in September. We'd lost our footy final, swan school bus, we all piled. Broken, battered, bloodied and bemused. The only consolation from the complete ego deflation would be a hot pie from the shop we couldn't lose. Dano got a 4 and 20 and Tomo he bought plenty. And Simo even got a sausage roll. But despite the rejection I risked with my selection, I couldn't help but feel like something cold. I bought a guitar, a golden guitar, 'cause this time it felt like the right time. A guitar, a golden guitar, gave me such a hard time for what I'd done. I just felt like ice cream wrapped in biscuit crumbs. The shopkeeper looked shifty as I handed him $1.50, and all around me time seemed to freeze. It was like a Western movie with the villain and his groupies, death stare in my iced confectionery. What do you think you're doing? It was Tomo, he was spewing, dirt flying off his footy spurs. If he says something you're not saying, what's this game you're playing? Can't have that for lunch, it's absurd. Oh, I bought a guitar, a golden guitar. This time it felt like the right time. A gay time, a golden gay time. It gave me such a hard time for what I'd done. I just felt like ice cream wrapped in biscuit crumbs. Everybody got back on the bus and everyone was in a real huff. My best mate Wade wouldn't sit next to me. Tomo was the leader, he kept calling me ice cream eater. I chose to take that literally. There's only so much I could take. Tomo's voice was giving me an ice cream headache. I didn't know whether to scream or spew. The only way to stop it was to point out that stain in Tomo's pocket. It was a half-melted ice cream that we all knew. He'd bought a gay time, a golden gay time. 'Cause this time it felt like the right time. A gay time, a golden gay time. Gave me such a hard time for what I'd done. I just felt like ice cream wrapped in biscuit crumbs. No longer will I settle for a billabong. I'm so proud to sing my gay time eating song.
Justin Hazelwood, the bedroom philosopher. You will see him at the University of Canberra in the refectory on Sunday night as part of ACT on Earth. He's going to be playing before Body Jar. He's going to be having a crack with some of his great songs. And, of course, Kelly will be there as well on stage at 6:20 if you want to catch Justin in his pyjamas giving you some bedroom philosophy. 25 minutes to 10. In a moment, we'll catch up with the young Australian of the year, the man who called himself a rock jock, Scott Hucknall. What's he been doing for the last 12 months? He's going to tell us soon. After we hear from the Chemical Brothers on Triple J.